Well, hello there, amazing people. This is a little bit of a different video. I was bored, so I got macOS Monterey, I think that's how you pronounce it, to work in VMware Workstation 17 Pro, or whatever it is. And you can see it's working here. Despite that, this is the serial number. I don't have a pass-through graphic card. Don't want to deal with that right now. I will explain a little bit later on why I don't want to do that. You know, my RAM, I gave it 8 gig. I gave it 6 cores. And you can see here that, yeah, it says here that it's a 30.5-inch display running 1080p. Yeah, that optimism. That's the kind of optimism I you know, tell myself every morning. I'm taking a morning pee and looking down on my manhood. And I'm like, yeah, it's a 30-inch. Hashtag ladies. Yeah, with 120 or almost 130 gigabytes, the memory again, one slot use, so I think it's only doing single channel memory emulating. That's why it's a little bit jerky-derky. Support and resources. I've installed some things just to, you know, fit around with it. And you can see here, it looks awful because I don't have 3D rendering or correct 3D rendering in it. You can use it, but again, it's not the best way. And if you're watching this and you're like, oh my god, he's now going to tell me how to do this so I can run macOS in a virtual machine with GPU pass-through and all of that, and I'm like, no. I'm going to show you how it looks like if you're willing to spend a little bit of time editing, you know, your config file. You have to go and edit your config file, and if you're running an AMD, you have to go and spoof the virtual machine to tell the VM that you're running an Intel by putting in some commands into your config file and stuff like that. I do have a Discord if you want help to set this up, and I can probably help you, but I'm not going to make a guide. If you are going to be, I'm going to be the fucking hardcore nerd of all hardcore nerds, and I'm going to find a GPU and do pass-through. You have to be really selective with the GPUs that you're using, and either they cost more than just buying a fucking Mac Mini or something like that if you want, or a second-hand Mac if you want to try and get into the ecosystem. One thing that I would do if I was you, I know it's throwing money out of the window, but it's still better than, you know, spending thousands of dollars. So I would go like with a 2014 Mac Mini or something like that. You can get them used really, 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 really cheap, and they can run Monterey. Yeah, late 2014, you can run it, and you can get it for like under 300 bucks. I would not pay much more than that. Maybe 200, 250 thereabouts. And yes, I know it's money out of the window if you decide not to use. But here's the thing. If you're not going to, you know, okay, you figure out, oh, macOS is not for me, or Mac is not for me, you now have an amazing fucking media station. You know, small form factor media station where you can put Plex on it. And you just throw Linux on it or Windows on it and use it as a media center. This has a use case that you're running this in a VM. This is you right now figuring out, do I like macOS? You see, I have downloaded Steam here. Of course, I can't play games on it. It don't support virtualization, 3D emulation. You can kind of set it up with a lot of fucking hacking and tweaking and stuff like that. And you can see it's really struggling here, like really, really struggling here. Virtual Studio Code works in it. I've been doing a little bit of funny coding in here just for fun. As you can see here, Chrome is working. You can, like, if you're just going to use this VM to watch unattainable television shows or movies and stuff like that, perfectly fine for that. You can watch YouTube and what have you not, with no problem whatsoever. If you like, it works perfectly as a consumption VM. No problem watch Mac TV with the Lightning. But again, you can watch Mac TV in any browser on any system. I think you can even do it under Linux. So this is not meant to be run as your main driver. Okay, buy a Mac Mini if you really, really want, you know, native hardware performance. And if you don't like macOS, put Linux on it or Windows on it. I'm just trying to show you guys and girls and ladies and robots here that it is doable. And if I go in here and I go into software updates, I can actually update to Ventura. But please don't do that, because this specific version of VMware, I tried this. And I tried all of the fixes to get it to work on YouTube. It kernel packs a boot loop. It goes into an infinite boot loop if I do this. And I even tried to make a new virtual machine with the Ventura ISO, and it still just boot loop when it's installed. Right now, oh, there's actually a Safari update. So you get updates to, like, right now I'm updating Safari. You can run it. The only thing you have to remember is that anything 3D related is massively slow. If I go in here and I look at the widgets over here, if I go in and edit them, you see how slow this is. If I click this one here, I don't know if there comes an update tomorrow or in a week that will break this VM. This is just for fun. See you all later. Bye-bye.